So we have seen that there are various digital modulation techniques. The main purpose of this technique is to, just before the transmission, we are converting, we are strengthening our signal, or we are sending our baseband signal in such a way so that the signal strength becomes stronger. If noise affects, it's easy for us to remove the noise from the signals when we are demodulating it. So taking the aim of, once we demodulate it, we should receive a better quality signal. This modulation is being done at the transmitter end. So we have seen that based on what kind of signal we are sending through noisy medium, or we are using through which kind of channel, we decide what should be the technique we should use. Now, we also know that the main signal, information signal, we have already converted into digital signal with the help of various techniques, that is pulse amplitude modulation, then that is PAM, then PPM, that is pulse position modulation, which is totally dependent on PWM or PDM, which is pulse duration modulation or pulse width modulation. And after everything is done, then we have done coding with the help of pulse code modulation. And then what we have received is this result, digital signal, which has ones and zeros. Now, based on what is the voltage we have got with the help of quantization and sampling, we have converted all our analog signal into voltages into bits. Now, these bits, we are calling it as a digital signal or an information signal. Now, to transmit, we are using the carrier signal. The carrier signal is of constant amplitude, constant frequency, constant phase. And now this we will be sending as a carrier signal. You can see here, AC indicates the constant amplitude or just an amplitude. Cos, as I said, it is more of a sinusoidal signal because you can see that it's analog in nature, so sinusoidal signal. Then we have 2 pi FC, that is omega C, that is an angular frequency. Then phi basically indicates the phase. Now, if you go ahead with ASK modulation, that is amplitude shift keying, the amplitudes are varying here. So when the digital signal says 1, the amplitude of a carrier is been as it is sent. If you say the digital signal is 0, then either amplitude becomes 0 or it becomes some other amplitude. So automatically 2 different amplitudes are sent at a time. Like this, multiple signals, multiple amplitudes can be sent with the help of the comp. This is only 1 and 0. Now, if you just increase the quantization level, it will become 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So you can see the number of levels are increasing. So naturally, 1s and 0s will also increase. Now, same way, if you talk about FSK, we have seen that if it is says 1, the same frequency of carrier is being sent. If it is 0, then the frequency is being changed. Now, for this, we can use different carrier with different frequencies so that we can send one particular frequency at a time with the bits that we are having, which symbolizes either 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, or still more. Same way, PSK. You can see the variation is happening only in phase. In FSK, it was only in frequency, and ASK, it was only amplitude. That means this carrier is varying ASK for amplitude, FC frequency for FSK, and this phase for PSK. Now you can see again, when there is a change happening between 1 to 0 and 0 to 1, only that time the phase shift is happening. So various techniques are being used for the modulation. Now, if you talk about ASK, PSK, and FSK in digital modulation, you can also use the various combination of amplitude and phase, frequency and phase, amplitude and frequency. The various names have been given to them. Then if you talk about ASK here, we have seen that ASK is basically on and off keying. Why we are saying on and off? The first example says that when it is 1, the carrier signal is passing as it is. When it is 0, the carrier signal is off. So signal is not passing. So on, off. That's the reason it can also be called as on, off keying. Also, we can do that when 1 is there, we can the signal that is passing is just carrier signal is passing by. whereas one zero is there, some different amplitude has been passing. Like this, two different amplitudes are passed. Now, as I said, here it was 1, 1, 1. So all ones were going, all carrier has been passed. When it was 0, 0, only zero has gone. Now here, with the different levels of quantization, you can get different forms of bits, like purely based on how much quantization we are doing. So with that, various different amplitudes can be sent at a time. Now here, an example has been given that if it says 2 sine 2 pi 4 t. Now remember, it says 2 pi fc t. So fc becomes your 4, that is frequency, and 2 indicates the amplitude. So here the amplitude of your carrier will be 2 and the frequency will be 4. So that is how the signal has been designed. Now based on that, sampling will be done and you will be having a digital sequence of series. Now here 0 is represented as one particular voltage, say we are calling it as 1 volt here, and 1 indicates 2 volts, so 2 volts is passing. That is how a ASK represents a signal. Now here, how it has been done. Now, we are already sending a stream of pulses, which we have already converted from analog to digital with the help of all the techniques of PAM, PWM, or PPM, and later on converted into PCM. Now that we have got as digital data, and carrier signal is having a fixed amplitude, fixed frequency, fixed phase. Now these both merge together in the mixer, and the ASK signal that we receive is with 1 and zeros. Now, to understand it more, you will see that we are representing the signal logic 1 as binary 1 and 0 as logic 0, right? So what we are saying, 2 pi fc is basically omega. Now, you have already seen that in amplitude modulation, we had an analog signal. We had analog carrier. The output that we have got was amplitude modulated signal. Now, this is the equation for analog amplitude modulated signal, which talks about carrier amplitude, and it talks about the frequency of the carrier, and also it changes itself. That means the main final signal is changing itself with the variation happening at the modulating signal. Now, if you talk about ASK, since why I have compared this ASK with amplitude analog modulation, because we are talking about amplitudes. When we talk about amplitudes, first thing what we have, if you compare these equation, first thing what you have done is you are taking only the positive half. You can see only positive half is passing by. So this A, that is amplitude, becomes A by 2. Okay. Then you can see a part of carrier is always present. So we are representing it as A by 2. A by 2, you know why? Because the amplitude is just half. We are not taking this lower sideband is not considered at all. We are talking only about upper sideband. So naturally, the amplitude has become half of it. So we have made it half. Then cos omega CT, we are talking about frequency of a carrier. Now we know that the amplitude of ASK is either having the amplitude of carrier or some other voltage. Now that some other voltage or some other frequency totally depends upon the input signal. So if this is for when the one is there, naturally this is when zero is there. We have seen in the previous year also, you can see either zero is represented as zero voltage or some other voltage. We are talking this as some other voltage, which will pass when it says logic zero. So now mathematically, the equation that we are having is 1 plus VMT A by 2 cos omega CT. If you see, it's the same equation, only we have taken A by 2 cos omega CT as common. That gives this particular equation. Now remember, how did we got this equation? We got this equation because we are removing the lower sideband. So once we remove the lower sideband, this A becomes half. Second thing is, the only two amplitudes can pass through it right now with this particular example. One is what is already present in the carrier when it says logic 1. And when it is logic zero, some other amplitude will go. Now that is purely our choice what we want to give it here. We can either make it zero or we can give some other voltage. Right now we are taking it as zero and moving on. Now here, now when your input signal, remember our input signal is a digital signal, when it says logic one, we are saying it's plus one voltage. When it says minus one, we are calling it as logic zero. Fine. Now here what happens when we are getting logic one? Only that one will get added to this. Now here you can see this VM that is plus one got added here to VMT. Now that makes it one. And then the final equation that we get is 2A by 2 cos omega CT. 2 and 2 get cancelled and we are left with A cos omega CT. That means when it says logic 1, we are getting A cos omega CT. Means entire carrier is being transferred through the digital 1. When it says 0, now when it is saying logic 0, your VMT is indicating as minus 1. That means 1 minus 1 makes it 0. That's the reason when it is logic 0, we are saying we are getting output as 0. Now, as I said, it all depends upon the person who is at the transmitter, what kind of signal you want to send. You can make it as minus 1. You can even make it as minus 2. In that case, what will happen when it is logic 0? Some other voltage will be passing through it. So we can either give the voltage as minus one or some other voltage so that two different amplitudes pass at a time, right? So this is how ASK is being planned. Now, when I talk about FSK, you can see here, again, we have a digital stream of input, which has some ones and zeros. Now we want to send one particular frequency when it is logic one and another frequency when it is logic zero. Now, in all three cases, you can see that amplitude is constant. What is changing is only frequency. Which frequency it is changing? Carrier frequency is been changing. So if you look at the output part, the output will be combination of two inputs, two different carriers with two different frequencies, but similar amplitudes. Now, here, different with different frequencies and different combination of PCM bits, various frequencies can pass through it. Like there's just an example they have shown that when it is 00, we are representing it with one particular frequency. 01 indicates with some another frequency, 10 with another, and 11 with another. All four are different frequencies. So like this, various frequencies get passed when we are talking about FSK. Now here, if we'll again look back to this particular equation, that here FSK and binary FSK is same because we are using binary bits here. So now the first carrier frequency that we have got, we are calling it as 2 pi F1 with frequency F1. Second one, we are calling it as F2. Now remember, what is our aim? Our aim is that the output that we get should have both the frequencies here. We are taking example only with two frequencies right now. So when it's binary one, F1 frequency should pass. And when it's binary zero, F2 frequency should pass. Now, how it happens? It basically happens is the frequency that is one, we call it as a mark, and zero, we are calling it as space for our understanding. Now here, if you go back again, you will find that the starting point of F1 frequency and F2 frequency is same. But as they move on with respect to time, it changes. Now here, when it changes from 1 to 0, here in F1, it starts with the frequency is here at 0. But in F2, it is not at 0. There is a small variation that is happening. Same way, when we go from 0 to 1, your frequency, again, if F1 is at 0, but what is happening F2? Again at zero, okay. As we move on from 1 to 0, you will find here it's again zero, here also zero. Okay, fine. Now when we merge both of them together, the difference that we have found when we are going from 1 to 0, that is at this particular point and at this point, the difference of frequencies at this particular point when it's crossing from 1 to 0 and 0 to 1, we are calling it as delta F. So what is delta F? Delta F is difference between second frequency with respect to the first. That we are talking as frequency deviation. If you remember, when you are doing FM modulation, you have come with this term of frequency deviation. There also, we were comparing the final output with the carrier frequency, and we are able to see that frequency is increasing or decreasing with respect to the input voltage. So that frequency deviation we are talking about here. So for that, we are comparing, we are keeping reference point as the first carrier frequency, and the deviation that is happening in the frequency with respect to the previous carrier, we are calling it as a frequency deviation. So our final equation of FSK basically has a constant amplitude, a sinusoidal wave, and center frequency. Now, this frequency deviation either has got added in the equation, in the frequency, or it is subtracted from the original frequency. So this frequency deviation will give you the information about how much frequency variation has happened. Now, regarding the phase shift, we know it is zero because we are talking about FSK right now.